Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here with mgrmusic.com, and today we're going to be learning how to tap. For the video today I'm using the East Coast Guitars GT100 and I'm plugged into the Blackstar Silverline Deluxe. The amp is mic'd with an Aston Origin condenser mic and my voice is being recorded with a Rode Go clip-on microphone. Two-handed tapping is a brilliant technique if you really want to impress someone with your guitar playing. It looks a lot harder to do than it is, and many players are almost afraid of it when they first start out. But you don't have to be afraid of it, it's not as difficult as you first imagine. So in this lesson we're going to look at a couple of different ways you can start to bring tapping into your guitar solos. Not only does it look great, but it also helps really build up some speed. You can get surprisingly quick without too much work here. So I'm going to be doing all the licks in this video using the A minor pentatonic scale. But I'm not going to be needing a pick for this video because I'm going to be using the index finger on my picking hand for the tap notes. So the first lick we're going to look at is a tapping lick with a fret hand hammer-on. So the fretting hand is going to be playing the 5th fret on the B string and doing a hammer-on to the 8th. Now if you imagine we're doing that on every single beat. Picking hand isn't going to be picking the string, but it's going to be tapping a note. So we're going to use the first finger to hit the 12th fret, just like you would if you were doing a hammer-on. We now need to combine that with what the fretting hand is doing. So rhythmically we're going in triplets here. 1 and a, 2 and a, 3 and a, 4 and a. So on every one of the beats, I'm tapping that 12th fret, and on the and a, I'm doing the hammer-on. So to get ready for this, I actually need to keep my index finger on the 5th fret, because when I do the tap and I pull that off, it actually sounds the 5th fret note. So I'm going to do the tap again, pull off to the 5, which is already in position, and then hammer on to the 8. So that's my first triplet. I'm going to do 4 of those now across the rest of that bar. Then I'm just going to move my tapping note up 1 fret to the 13 and repeat that again. So that gives me 2 bars of a tapping lick. Now the great thing here is I can get pretty quick with this, because all I'm really doing is hammer-ons with this hand and essentially a hammer-on and pull-off with this hand. So we can build up that speed pretty fast. The tap notes are just coming from the natural minor scale. So I'm tapping that 12th fret, which is a B note, which is in the natural minor scale. And I'm also tapping the 13, which is a C, which is in my minor pentatonic. I can tap any note I want as long as it's in the scale. So I could actually use the 10th fret because that's in the second shape of the minor pentatonic. Or likewise, I could use the 15th fret because that's in the 4th shape of the minor pentatonic. But I could also move that note each time. And that brings me nicely onto the second tapping lick we're going to look at, which is the same idea, but instead of doing a hammer-on with the fret in hand, we're doing a pull-off. So we'll set this up in a similar way. My first finger is going to be on the 5th fret of the B, and my little finger is actually going to be on the 8th fret of the B ready. This is so I can do that pull-off. So I'm going to do the tap at the 12th fret, pull off to the 8th fret, and then pull the little finger off to the first finger on the 5th. The rhythmic groupings here are exactly the same, so once again it's triplets. So once again, it's pretty easy to get the speed up there, and the same principles apply about moving that tap note to other notes of the minor pentatonic. And the third and final tapping trick we're going to look at in this lesson is tapping off the back of a string bend. So if you want, you can bring your pick back into things for this, or you can play the string with your finger. This is totally down to whatever you're playing and whatever your preferred style is. So I'm going to use a pick for this just to demonstrate the initial idea. So here's what we're going to do, and then we'll break down the technique. So while this one may look a little tricky, it's not as difficult as you'd imagine. What we're actually doing is we're bending the 7th fret on the G, which is a minor pentatonic note. I'm doing a full tone bend there, and then once the bend is at its peak, I'm tapping another pentatonic note with the middle finger of my picking hand. So the first note I'm tapping is the 12th fret, which is between the 3rd and 4th shapes. Then I'm hitting the 14th fret, which is between the 4th and 5th shapes. Next up is the 17th fret, which is the 5th to the 1st shape. And then the final note I'm tapping is the 19th fret, which is between the 1st and 2nd shapes. When I'm doing the picking for that lick, I'm not being super precise. I'm actually muting the E, A, and D strings and just raking down into that note on the G. You don't have to be super accurate with a lick like this because the chances are you're going to put that one in the heat of the solo. You could be playing a rock lick like this. And you may decide to throw a tap in there at the end. And that really takes the lick to a different place. Bending and putting a tap at the end is a great way to open up the fretboard. You're targeting other notes from your pentatonic scale. So there you go, guys. There are three easy concepts to get you started with two-handed tapping. You can start to put some of those ideas into your guitar solos straight away. It's a great way of building some speed in your solos, and also it looks quite impressive. You may have found by trying this out, it's not as hard as you first may have imagined. So now you can go and put some of that stuff into your own lead guitar parts. And please let us know down below in the comments how you guys got on with that technique and what use you've gotten from it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out PMTV UK on YouTube for more free lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area, please head over to mgrmusic.com. There's a network of great teachers all over the UK just waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you soon.